My name is EJ Murphy, and I am an instructor here at PCC in the Fundamentals of Engineering. I also work as an energy analyst for the Oregon Department of Energy.
My name is Jenna Hori, and in 2007, I graduated with a degree in civil engineering, and I've been working for the past 5 years at a private engineering consulting firm in transportation engineering.
My name is Corrine Nuss, and I worked for Boeing 27 years, and I was as a manufacturing engineer.
My name is Carol Roarke, and I worked as a computer programmer for North American Aviation on the Apollo project, and then later for Rockwell International for the Space Shuttle project.
The company I worked for is David Evans & Associates, and they traditionally have done a lot of work in transportation engineering, which is the field that I went into, and I started off kind of more as a, I guess, generalist, for lack of a better way to put it, and I actually fell into becoming a track engineer. That's sort of the specialty I was heading into for the past couple of years, just kind of through luck and opportunity. That's what they needed, and it's been really interesting. 5 years of experience, I was working really independently and in meetings with people, you know, way above my level, and kind of being the only representative from the track design side, kind of speaking up amongst people that had, you know, 20 years of experience and kind of sitting at the table as a peer. So that was really great. I mean, that was probably the most difficult part of my job, but also the most fun and rewarding.
I think I was the first woman manufacturing engineer in the aerospace business throughout the United States. And I'm not sure of that, but I think that I was. And so did my supervisors think that I was. Anyway, I was rather proud of that.
The earth shook, and you watched it. And you know, the feeling you got was pride. I was so proud, not only proud of myself and the workers, but proud of the United States.
No one discouraged me. And I would say I would never have gotten into the field I did get into if it wouldn't have been for the war, World War II. And women had to go to work. I don't think very many of us realize how close we come to losing that war.
I don't think I knew engineering was going to be where I would end up. I did not in high school decide that that was what I was going to be. I had an uncle who was an engineer, and that's the full total sum of what I knew he did. I knew I liked the sciences, and I knew I liked science and math. It made sense to me. And I also knew that I wanted to make a good living. And it seemed to me that my uncle made a good living.
I don't know if I ever really knew that I wanted to work in engineering. I guess I was lucky that I had some engineers in my family as, I guess, examples. And so I had some exposure enough to kind of know, you know, the name civil engineering as a title of a field I could possibly work in, even if as a kid I really didn't know what that meant. But I was always pretty good in math. That was probably my strongest subject. So I just heard over and over, you know, you should go into engineering. Oh, you're so good at math, go into engineering. And so I guess I kind of did, just because I'd heard that so much. And I guess I, you know, was very, very fortunate to get that encouragement.
My dad had a really sharp mind for mathematics. I wanted to become a math teacher because of the math teacher I had in high school. He made math fun, just absolute fun. I used to go home and make up numbers and things to play with, and that was my entertainment.
I had a very encouraging chemistry teacher. You know, it just takes one teacher to give you the confidence that, hey, I could do this.
When it came to this new field of computers, I fell in love with that too because of that teacher. So basically, it boils down to teachers, good teachers.
My college was a very, very positive experience for me. Graduate school was not so much. I was the only female in my entering class in my core study group. I had two professors in particular that actively discouraged me from being there. I don't care. They were a minor impediment. I had to get over, around, through them somehow, and they were going to be behind me.
We got to get good quality teachers to teach these kids.
I think any young girl that is maybe not feeling capable enough to get into a man's world shouldn't feel that way. You should hold your head up, dress nicely, always look your very best, and do your very best, and you won't have a bit of trouble.
I don't feel like there were any obstacles in my way because of my gender in terms of, you know, getting into the civil engineering department or making my way through school in that field or getting my job. You know, I feel like it's been pretty easy for me. I guess the only thing that really sort of irked me is a few times in college, as we were kind of nearing the end, some of my male friends would kind of express concern about finding a job and would say things like, well, of course you'll get a job because you're a girl, and would kind of imply that sort of the reverse discrimination, companies would be looking to hire me because I'm a woman in engineering, and that was, you know, more rare, or that, you know, they would be pick me because of that, and that really bothered me. I felt like they're gonna hire me because my grades were better than yours, or I speak well in interviews. I mean, that really ticked me off that, and I felt like they would think that, and I'm sure some people do. And so that's the only thing that ever really bothered me, and it, you know, it's not a big deal.
The town of Downey, California, where the plant was for both the Apollo and the space shuttle, 90% of the people around there worked there. So, I mean, we all had something in common. This little tiny town just, you know, blossomed. So there wasn't any. In fact, you'd meet somebody and say, what department do you work in? You know, you didn't ask what store or, you know, anything. It was, what department do you work in?
I will say that Boeing was very fair. So was the other aircraft that I worked for, Consolidated Vultee. They always gave me raises, same raises. I will say the only thing that maybe I had to work a little harder, and if I wanted to make a decision that was a fairly substantial decision, if it were a man, it went right through. Mine, they always looked over. And other than that, I would say I was treated just as well as the men.
My boss was a woman, and she was a great boss, by the way. She's very excellent. There are several other women that I really looked up to at my company that were in kind of a senior technical engineer position.
There is no Prince Charming. You are in charge. You are responsible. Go make it happen for yourself. And, you know, have fun. It's fun.
For the past couple of years, I've been working on the Columbia River Crossing project, which is a huge mega project. And I was working on the track design for the light rail portion of that project. So that's also just been kind of amazing as kind of a junior level engineer. It's kind of been fun to work on a high profile project.
I would say set a goal. Always set a goal and work toward that goal.
Culture is very strong, so there may be a number of women that it just never even occurs to them that this is something they could do. If as a woman you recognize that you want to have a family and understand how challenging that can be at times, just doing that, just raising a family, and then trying to meld that with a challenging career, it can be daunting. And you can't do it alone. You absolutely have to have support. So that's something that sometimes I think may be the case, is that they look at the challenges and the responsibilities of both a career and a family, and they don't know how they can do it, but it can be done.
I had a child 8 months ago, and I decided to quit my job, and I'm going to be a stay-at-home mom for a while and try to get back into the field in a few years, and we'll see how that goes.
I didn't work the first 5 years. I stayed home and took care of Bradley, my son. Then we were poor too. You know, it was hard for a young couple with a child. And I had an opportunity to get a job at Consolidated Vaulty, and I took it. And it was strictly for financial reasons. I had told God that I would never be poor again, and I intended to keep that commitment.
If I could encourage young women that are interested in the sciences and math, develop your own abilities. Don't worry about fitting into someone else's picture of what you should be. Because if you are true to yourself and you do good work and you're an honorable person and you participate in a positive manner, again, I don't want to sound like a Pollyanna, you will have opportunities that are just phenomenal. Take a chance, risk something, do something. If you don't fail from time to time, you're really not trying.